Sing was originally inspired by a cup of tea. I had a cup of tea with Chris Meledandri, who started and is the main producer of Illumination. And he sat me down and we just started talking about the kind of things we wanted to make, and that involved music, that involved animals, and it involved some kind of competition to, you know, to see, and put to see characters going through that kind of a journey is just so appealing. And that's how it started. And it literally started with that, a cup of tea and a chat about these things, and then it snowballed into this extraordinary event we're about to enter into, yeah.
You walk us through our main characters and the astonishing voice cast you've assembled to play them.
It is astonishing, isn't it? The voice cast is ridiculous. Okay, so you have, at the centre of the story, you have Matthew McConaughey playing Buster Moon, who is a koala who runs a theatre, and it's not doing so good, so he stages a live singing competition in the hopes that it'll bring people back. And then around him you have... you follow the contestants that are part of his show. One of them is played by Seth MacFarlane. He plays a really nasty, spiteful, egotistical mouse. But he can sing beautifully. Then you have Tori Kelly playing Mina the elephant, who suffers from the most appalling stage fright, to the point where she just can't even speak. Then you have Scarlett Johansson, who's playing Ash the porcupine, who's in a terrible relationship with her, with this awful boyfriend of hers, who's very boring and under, you know, keeps her under his thumb. And she really needs to get out from under that. And then you've got Reese Witherspoon, who plays Rosita the pig, who is married and has 25 piglets and is struggling like mad to try and reconnect with that part of herself that she had to let go of in order to have a family. And finally, the final member of the cast is played by Taron Egerton. He plays a gorilla called Johnny, who's a British Cockney gorilla who is his father's getaway driver because his dad's a gangster. And he is trying to lead a double life between rehearsing for Buster's show and trying to keep up with his dad's demands. Can imagine where that goes. Yeah.
Of course, Matthew's character is the heart of this story. Can you talk about what he brought to the role and just a little bit more about Buster?
Well, you only need to see Matthew in one movie to realize that man is like a thunderbolt. And he brought this unbelievable personality. Really, you need that energy, that enthusiasm. And you need that enthusiasm to be infectious, not obnoxious. And he just has this charm that is inherent in everything he does. And I couldn't be happier. It's a dream to have someone like that just jump in and just get it from the outset.